Ladies and gentlemen, today I'm not going to be reading a letter. If you want to hear Chris's newest letter read, there is a link in the description and the video is on screen from someone called Stories from the Penitentiary. And they sent a letter to Chris and they read it on their video. And that's below if you want to see it. This video is me giving you the bullet points and the highlights of this Chris letter. And man, is it fucking, it's pretty far fucking out there. You know, there's a lot of Jesus shit in all this, but there's a lot of things you can take away from this letter. I think this is the most informative letter yet. Chris lets us in on some big details. Like, number one here, Chris has gotten over 35 letters. He just hasn't had paper to write everyone back with. But it's wild, thinking I've only read about 6 or 7 of these, there may be as many as 30 to 40 out there. It seems like more people than I originally thought are sending Chris letters. Now, I'm not surprised. I'm just surprised it was this soon before he got like that many. Nonetheless, another thing Chris brought up is that he hasn't been dealing with any noisy neighbors other than when he was in booking. So I guess he was getting annoyed by other prisoners while he was in the process of being booked, and Chris bought a pair of earbuds for 80 cents and told us that it was a very good investment. But Chris having noisy neighbors ties into our next subject, which he confirmed a lot of people's suspicions that Chris is not being kept near any other prisoners for his own safety. Now, there's points in this letter where Chris says some confusing shit, and I'm not sure if he means the prisoners themselves, but he says like he's meditating and there are some really powerful forces here in this, like, wherever the fuck he's at. Because you'll know, I'll get into it in a little bit, you're not going to believe where Chris thinks he's at right now, or at least says he's at right now. It's pretty fucking out there. Chris says that he gets along with higher up officers and a lot of medical personnel because they give off a better aura. And they're much more kind to him. So, I think what that means is that Chris is dealing with the fucking normal, like, guards, and he thinks they're a bunch of jerk-ops, and then whenever he gets, like, taken to an office or something, they treat him like a fucking baby. So, that's how it's gonna be in the courtroom. They're gonna treat him like a fucking child. I fucking hope they don't, though. I hope they treat him like a person who did what he did to his mom. You know, they better not let Chris off easy with this, but they probably will. Another thing is that Chris, he alluded to something about ponies. I don't know if he thinks that the other prisoners want to attack him because he's a pony. That's what I took from what Chris said. Most likely wasn't what he meant, but when Chris says it, it sounded like, yeah, like he's an alicorn or some shit. I don't know what that means. All I know is that Chris thinks he's one of them, and I'm pretty sure he thinks that other fucking inmates are going to attack him for being said alicorn. So that's why Chris is being kept away. At least he believes that. Chris claims to spend most days meditating in there. I guess that's what he's doing to keep himself from going absolutely crazy. I mean, what am I saying? He's already fucking crazy, but he's been meditating. But he says it's because of some weird-ass Simpsons shit. Like, Bart was doing something with his soul, yada, yada, yada. So that's where Chris got it from. But if you know Chris, he takes everything he sees on TV, cartoon or not, reality show or not, doesn't matter what it is, he'll fucking believe it. And oh, ladies and gentlemen, we are about to get into much more Simpsons shit. Because Chris then went on to say that he's been reading a lot of the Bible and the Quran. And the Quran is much more like Family Guy, while the Bible is much more like The Simpsons. And, you know, when you think about it, God does kind of remind me of Homer. You know, like, I can see it. I don't know nothing about the Quran, but apparently Chris sees Peter fucking Griffin in that bitch. All jokes aside, how much of a lunatic do you have to be to say something like that completely seriously? Just put that in a letter that you're sending to someone and expect them to take that seriously. You saying that the Quran and the Bible are on par with Family Guy and The Simpsons, respectively. Someone better put that shit on a shirt. Family Guy equals Quran. Simpsons equals Bible. Chris may have just figured out everything right there, honestly. But just what a line that is. At one point, Chris refers to his jail cell as, and I quote, a fancy penthouse. Earlier in the letter, I didn't really know where to put it, but Chris mentioned something about so-and-so selling him on the place. So Chris really is diving into the delusion that he's there by choice and that the place is like it's a pretty good establishment. It's not the best, but you know, we're getting by. And, you know, Chris also mentions that they have some grape Fanta down at the commissary, and man, you know he was just scratching at the bit to get his fucking hands on some orange Fanta, make it feel a little more like home. But yeah, just Chris really is farther and farther putting himself in the delusion that he's there by choice and this is some vacation or some shit. Chris at one point says that his things he misses the most from home are playing Tetris 99 and having internet access to watch the videos he likes to watch. So basically, he just wants to be playing video games with videos in the background. Like any lazy fuck does all day long. Sits there, just plays their games, listens to YouTube videos, yada yada yada. You know, I do that on a weekend sometimes when I don't have work and just sit around, sit on my ass all day. You know Chris does that shit all day, every day, and him not being able to do that is just eating him up inside. And so he mentioned to this guy, yeah, that's what Chris misses the most. And I'd wondered that. I'd wondered if it was the Sonichu shit. I wondered if it was like his My Little Pony shit that he was like getting nuts to get out for. And he definitely is. He's obviously missing that shit. He wouldn't have brought it up in his first court hearing and said like he needs to go home and get that shit if he didn't feel that way. But I think right now, yeah, he's just really missing Tetris 99. And I'm sorry, no fucking way Chris ever even got into like the top 25 in Tetris 99. Like, I used to be able to win Super Mario 99 games, like, every day, but Tetris 99 is a bit of a motherfucker. People can just throw shit at you, so I don't think Chris was really, I don't know. I would love to play Chris in Tetris, because I would smoke his ass. My biggest takeaway from this, and we're not done yet, ladies and gentlemen, we still have a lot more, but what I'm about to talk about next is what I really honed in on, and that was that Chris claims that he's been writing a journal in there. That's something that he said in many of these letters, but he went a little more in detail and said that he's quote-unquote not the only one who's been writing in there. Now, I don't know what that means. I'm going to assume it means one of these like little personas he has, like Sonichu wrote in there, or maybe he telepathically talked to someone and they wrote in there. That's probably what he means. At first, I was thinking like, holy shit, like, was it another prisoner or someone he's talking to? Was it like, I don't know. But Chris said we'll eventually get to see this once he gets out, and oh fucking man, I'm more excited about this jail journal than I am any Sonichu comic. Like, this journal is going to be the delusional ramblings of an absolute madman, and I just, that's something I cannot wait to get my hands on a copy of once Chris is out of jail, seeing what the fuck he's been writing in that journal. There was another thing that struck me, and that's that Chris admitted that he's been playing solitaire, and you know, that's good. Chris can get his mind off it. Then he said he's been playing solitaire on the Turkish prayer rug that he bought from commissary. Now, I had a lot of commenters back when I was talking about the quick Islam stuff and how Chris was like just doing all the disrespectful shit towards Islam and had a prayer rug. And a lot of people told me, you know, that's not a good thing for him to do. That's disrespecting some religions. Well, now Chris is fucking just playing solitaire on it and playing cards. I don't know. That seems pretty goddamn disrespectful, too. So Chris doesn't seem to understand, like, etiquette or like just boundaries and shit you don't do. So yeah, Chris is just playing cards on his Turkish prayer rug, but like I said, he's not near any prisoners, so I don't know anyone who would even see this and like, you know, try to go after him. And like I said, Chris mentioned it earlier in the letter, he's kept away for his own safety, and that's for the truth. If Chris would say some stupid shit to a prisoner and probably get someone to beat the fuck out of him. This was another letter, like I said, to really open people's eyes and see, man, like, Chris really is off the deep end. He doesn't understand that he's not, like, he's in some serious shit, and he keeps trying to dilute himself and go into some fantasy world where he's at some normal establishment having a nice little vacation away from home, and it's just fucking crazy, man. I think this letter in particular, like I said, delved more into everything going on than most of the other ones have, because, yeah, there was a lot of, like, Jesus shit and all that in here, but I kept that out, and in future readings, I probably won't be able to, because I'll be reading the letter myself, but this was just when I saw Stories from the Penitentiary's video, I knew I had to make at least an update and let you guys know what Chris said and what's going on, because we're getting closer and closer. We're only a couple days away from the next possible hearing date, and if they are using any of these letters and all in the court, which I don't know if they are, I don't need people in the comments to speculate on that. You can if you want, but I've had tons of people tell me that they are or they aren't. I don't know. I don't think that necessarily matters at this point. What matters is that Chris has 35 fucking people sending him letters, and if he writes back to all them, he'll be admitting so much dumb shit, because just in these first couple letters we've seen alone, he's admitted to doing what he did to Barb, he admits to thinking he's Jesus, he admits to having a Turkish prayer rug in which he just fucking plays cards on and disrespects. He thinks he's in a fancy penthouse. He says it's 2 out of 5 stars. Chris is just off the deep end. One other funny thing I want to mention is the stories from the penitentiary, the guy who got this letter. Chris sent him, I guess, a care package of stuff for his family, and brother, I'd throw that stuff out. Anything that Chris puts his hands on, I would never put my hands on. It's fucking, Like, I remember there's a story of Chris sending locks of his hair to the Sonichu girls back in the day and them saying how it had some grease, how greasy it was. I don't like that. I'm getting, like, fucking cringe down my spine right now just thinking about, I don't know. No, I would never, I don't even want to be in the same vicinity as Chris, ever. And, but I'll tell you what, these letters keep getting funnier while they get crazier, and like I said, I promised y'all I'll keep y'all updated, and that's what this was. But I already mentioned it a few times. I think the biggest takeaways here are Chris's amazing Quran is like Family Guy, Simpsons is like the Bible line, like just fucking poetry in its finest form right there. You can't tell me it's not. That is just brilliant. And I said the 35 letters is a big takeaway just because, you know, it's... There's going to be a lot more coming out there. I think people might be a little afraid of sharing them after seeing, like... But if you're just writing normal shit like this guy is, I don't understand why you'd be afraid. Like, this dude was just asking Chris questions, obviously. He's obviously not some ween going after Chris like the fucking quick Islam people and shit like that. Or the people asking if he fucked a pillow. So, if you have interesting things to write Chris and you're going to, like... be serious about it, you know, do you. I wouldn't do it myself, but, you know, everyone's their own person. Nonetheless, new Smoke Show dropping this week. Isabella Jank updates in it and everything, and that crazy YouTuber I was telling y'all about. I was being caught up in shit for the past few days, so I apologize. Other than that, ladies and gentlemen, thank y'all for the support, and, you know, it's not going to be long till Chris is hearing. Get excited. Get excited, boys and girls.